Well, hello everyone. Welcome to P.B.M. Vending. Today, I want to talk about our seven streams of income. And I don't mean me. I mean the ministry. Now, let me just give you a brief thing. It started a couple of years ago when I'm to a certain age where I'm concerned about what's going to happen to the ministry after I'm gone. And I thought, boy, it's a lot of work. There's no pay. So I was concerned about somebody taking it over because of the expense. So I wanted to cover the expense. And I kind of thought of it biblically, like when David prepared everything for his son to take over for the temple, and David provided all the material. That's kind of how I looked at it. And I really haven't given it much thought. I just kind of did what I thought was right and through prayer. And the last one I opened, I went back and thought about it. I thought, wow, we've got seven streams of income coming in. Now, one of them, the first one, I'm not really sure I would count it as a stream of income, but I put it on here because it's kind of an emotional thing. When our ministry started about 15 years ago, we had no money. And I wasn't making any money at all. So the only way that I had to have some things to get our up and running. So what I did was I went around and started collecting cans, aluminum cans. And then once a year, I would go cash them in and take that money and buy supplies that I would need for the year for the ministry. I worked really hard on those cans, and I still do that today. I still take them in, and of course the prices have gone way down. But now I do it just as a reminder as to how far our ministry has come. And I still take them in, so it is still income technically, but not much. But I did count it. Now, also because it's a ministry, I did not put the obvious stream of income that everybody would say, and that's a job. So I'm not counting that. Now the first one is tithing. I started tithing to our ministry years ago. And I did it after long time in prayer and decided that because I was teaching a Bible study class and teaching on the internet and all of that, that would be appropriate. So I have been tithing 10% of, well, actually a lot more than that. Again, because of prayer, but that's another issue. But tithing is number one. Number two was the cans. Now the third one is one that we just started, and that is dividends from stocks. And I, as an example, I did some research, and we opened it up through Robinhood, and I still can't believe I found this one. I put $500 into this one stock, and they pay monthly. And we just got our first dividend check yesterday, $14 and some change. Now, that doesn't sound like much, but think about this. So roughly $15 times 12 is $180 in a year. If I kept that same $500 in a bank, I would have made, if I was lucky, $5. Big difference. So that's, we're going to continue to search out dividend stocks, and each month we'll have some checks coming in. Now, the other one, right now we're not having any come in because the guy that's living in our little rental house is a piece of crud. And he's been living there for free for almost a year. But we did buy a little rental house with ministry money, and we will rent it out. And when we ever get control of it again and we rent it out, that will be a source of income for our ministry, a nice source. Now the next one, I want to think about it as short-term and long-term, and I almost counted them as two, but I decided that I would count it as one, but make a distinction. And it's interest on savings. Now, why would you count interest? Well, if you remember the story in the Bible where Jesus gives three people the money, and the last one comes back and says, I know you were a hard man, so I buried it in my backyard, and here's your money back. And Jesus says, you wicked man. The least you could have done was put it in the bank and so I could make interest. So Jesus counted it as income, so we're counting it as income. Now we have two forms. We have the savings account at the bank, or the credit union actually, for short-term purchases. And then we've got the interest in our mutual fund that's for investments and long-term. So there's two different types of interest that we're making on ministry money. Another source of income is from our bulk candy machines. And we're not making a lot right now, and that's okay. Right now we're investing, we're placing, we're purchasing, we're doing all the things, but we're making some money. Like the last time we collected, I only did one or two and we made like 40 something dollars. So I mean, it is a nice source of income, and when we get up and running, my goal is to have 100 machines, and each the average is $30. So I mean, even if we only make $1,000, that's $1,000 a month for our ministry. So that'll be good. And then the last one is donations. Now, before COVID, I was teaching a Bible study class, and I would pass around the jar, and they'd throw a couple of bucks in. I ended up losing money because I spent money for food every week, which was fine, but it did offset the cost. And then I've got one or two people that really love our ministry, and this guy went out on his. He sends me checks, one or two checks a year. For this year, he had a big year, and he has sent me a total of $800 or $900 this year in just two checks. But he opened his business, and he says he tithes to our ministry and one of his relatives' ministries. So I get a check, they get a check. I get a check, they get a check. So donations, and that's been a nice little thing. So we got seven sources of streams of income. We got tithing, the cans, income from dividend stocks, rent on our rental house. Number five would be the interest on our short-term and long-term savings accounts. Number six would be our bulk candy machines, and number seven would be donations. Now, none of them bringing in a lot, but they're all in line of orders of pretty much passive income. Now all we do is put it on autopilot and let God deal with how much and when and where and what to do with it. But it's set to go. But I wanted to run through, I did not set out to do that, but when I realized that that was happening to our little ministry, think about what you could do with your situation. You could get candy machines, you could do cans, you could do interest on a savings account, you could do all kinds of things to get passive income coming in to augment your income. Now, it's not going to be a lot, but as time goes by and you continue to do the right things over and over, that will increase. Just like with dividend stocks, we got $15 this month, and for 1 month, so that's $180 for a year. Okay, but if I add to it $500 every 6 months, that will double it each year. So, but just little things to build a little income to help you survive. Well, that's the 7 streams of income that we had for our ministry. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Otherwise, you guys have a great week and happy vending.